Morning, everyone. The fallout continues this morning after the shock resignation of Peter Slipper. Labor's Anna Burke has taken over the role as the new Speaker in Parliament after being elected to the job in a late-night session. For more on this, we're joined now by our political reporter Amanda Hart at Parliament House in Canberra. Amanda, what are the implications of all of this for the federal government?
Well, Ron, really it means that the government is going to struggle to get legislation through on the floor of the House. Now that Peter Slipper is sitting as an independent, the Coalition could potentially have an extra vote there because Mr. Slipper is probably more inclined to vote conservatively. And of course, the government is going to have to fight extra hard to win over those independents who aren't aligned politically. Now, this, of course, is just fodder for the opposition this morning. They were really ramping up their attack on the Prime Minister and the government for defending the former Speaker. Peter Slipper heads back to Parliament for his first day as an independent.
Mr. Slipper, do you think you're unfairly treated?
Last night, near breaking point, he brought to an end his tumultuous 11-month term as Speaker.
With great sadness, I have decided that I should not continue as your Speaker.
Mr. Slipper's resignation came just 3 hours after he survived an opposition attempt to sack him by just one vote. Now the spotlight is on the Prime Minister for defending the Speaker, even after the release of his obscene and degrading text messages.
Peter Slipper showed the judgment yesterday in resigning that the Prime Minister failed to show yesterday afternoon when she led the Peter Slipper defence team.
The Prime Minister is now using gender as a shield against any criticism of her performance, her honesty, her competence.
Senior ministers today standing by the decision not to sack Mr. Slipper, insisting they couldn't act as a kangaroo court.
I seriously don't want to interrupt, but it wasn't before the court. But it wasn't before the court. I'm talking about whether he should be Speaker or not.
But relief all round that the assault on the Speaker is now over.
What he has done is to fall on his sword and resign. I think that's the right decision.
Some in the government are now trying to turn the debate back on Tony Abbott.
First, that is to apologise for his sexist comments that he made, and second, to come in to the parliament and resign.
Questions also about whether the opposition will accept Mr. Slipper's vote after denouncing the government for accepting the so-called tainted vote of former Labor MP Craig Thompson.
Peter Slipper and Craig Thompson are two very different cases.
But in Parliament this morning, calm had returned as new elected Speaker Anna Burke took the chair. Independent Tony Windsor revealed this morning that he, along with fellow independent Rob Oakeshott, actually went to see Mr. Slipper yesterday afternoon to say that his position had become untenable and he should resign as Speaker. This was before the Coalition put the motion before the House to try to get rid of Mr. Slipper as Speaker. Now, Mr. Windsor also said this morning that health-wise, Mr. Slipper isn't a well man.
Amanda Hart reporting live from Parliament House in Canberra.